Welcome back, everyone. We.
You hear us okay?
Yeah. We are watching this tornado warning right now.
Baltimore County, Anne Arundel County. We've got Lowell Melso here. And
we weren't gone long. I knew this was going to happen just because the you can't take any chances with this. And I apologize for cutting into the soaps, but it's important information that we got to get out there for folks now. As you mentioned, Theo, in portions of northern Anne Arundel County, we have southern Baltimore City and as well as southern southeastern Baltimore County. So if you're in that area that's shaded red, I'd even say the area's in orange too, seek shelter immediately, as the National Weather Service is fairly confident that there's something mixing up there that could bring with it the possibility of spawning a tornado. And just taking a closer look at the radar here, you can see a very well-defined line of storms starting in the yellow there. We were talking about earlier with Ava. The good thing is that we weren't seeing a lot of lightning, and at this point, I'm not seeing many areas that look like purple, which would indicate hail.
Let me ask you, because I was literally getting ready to walk out of the building and get onto 83, and then onto the Beltway.
Right.
Probably not a good idea right now.
No, I would stay for folks that need to travel. And this is, you know, it's funny. Deborah Wiener asked me yesterday. She's like, you know, her parents were thinking of driving to the beach.
And that's what a lot of folks are trying to do.
And delay it. Delay. Wait for this stuff to go, because it is not a fun drive on the Beltway right now. And as well as portions of 795, as you can see there, just absolute blinding rain that's coming down right now associated with this cold front that continues to make its way through here and bring with it the possibility of some
tornadoes. Memorial Day traffic anyway, they say either leave early or leave late, so this kind of fell right in the middle. We were going to do that anyway, hopefully, for travelers. We do have Tony Pan on the line.
Yes.
So let's get him into this mix. Tony, where are you? What are you seeing?
Hi, guys.
What's going on? Hey.
Yeah, I'm in Baltimore County. Lowell, let's do a little radar analysis here. I'm not in front of a TV, so I can't see what you have up. But if you were to take like a wide view here, the thing you want to look for with this line of storms coming through from Baltimore County down into Anne Arundel County, you see how the line kind of snakes, like it makes a snake pattern?
Sure.
Any point that you see the little bows sticking out ahead of the main line, those are the parts of the storms that could be rotating. And the thing is that it's very difficult to pick up the rotation in this kind of a situation. So like if you were showing the velocity, and I'm sure you were a little while ago.
Yes.
You probably didn't see the red and the green together like you typically would. Is that correct?
Correct. Yeah, they were kind of no areas of real concern, right?
Right. But we know that these little pieces are rotating because they're starting to bow out. If that line was like straight up and down, then you'd say, okay, this is just a line of thunderstorms coming through. But each one of those little notches that you see that bow out, and you can point to them there, those are potential areas of rotation. So right now they have the Weather Service, a tornado warning in effect for the Glen Burnie area up towards Dundalk. It clips the Inner Harbor. If you're watching there, obviously you head to the basement immediately. But if you're in Towson or Cockeysville or Parkville or Middle River or Lakeshore north of Annapolis, Baltimore City, at least the eastern part of Baltimore City, you should take shelter now just in case, because it's, like I said, it's really hard to pick up these little spin tornadoes that are embedded in this. So a tornado in this kind of a situation might only last for 5 minutes.
Right.
And so it can be in between the radar cycles, so you don't actually see the rotation, but the tornado already happened. So that's why I would say anywhere from, okay, well, the line's heading over towards Harford County now. It's going to get ready to cross the bay. So if you're in the eastern part of Baltimore County, Middle River, and then up towards Kingsville in Harford County, it's going through the Cockeysville-Timonium area right now. Anywhere east of that line, you should take shelter just in case. That would be my advice. And it's only going to last like 15 or 20 minutes. So if it's an inconvenience, so what? You do it. just in case, because these little spin-up tornadoes can pop up, and there may not even be a warning on the part of the storm that's coming through your area. So that would be my advice to everybody right now.
Yeah, and just while I have the radar up here, if we're looking at cities that should take caution, I think around the Lakeshore area, I think around Arnold, we're seeing a couple of these, Riviera Beach also, as the storm
exactly.
is getting very close to them. To seek shelter immediately, because that's where we are seeing some of these kind of hooks a little bit that are coming out of the straight line. Yeah, and I'm going to pull up the velocity here, but as you mentioned, Tony, and we talked about, there aren't too many areas of concern. I mean, if I'm looking closer now, the areas I just mentioned, actually, Lakeshore has some pretty strong toward and away around that area, as well as mm-hmm. Riviera Beach. So yeah, there definitely could be something that's rotating there, and something certainly to keep a close eye on.
Yeah, what's happening now is that the storms are starting to interact with the bay breeze.
Mm-hmm.
So the bay breeze helps to create more spin in the storm. So they're more likely to create these little spin-up tornadoes when this line of storms gets close to the western shore of the Chesapeake Bay.
Tony,
so those areas you mentioned for sure. Yes, go ahead.
So I'm sorry, no, keep going. But I do have a question regarding kind of where you're going with that.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm just going to ask, is it good or bad for this situation to be going over a body of water?
Well, the body of water is what's creating the spin in these little storms to begin with.
Okay.
So it's bad in this kind of a situation. Whenever you see, I like to use BWI as a marker. When you see BWI's wind go southeast in this kind of a situation, that means the bay breeze has kicked in, and that means that there's low-level rotation, meaning the surface winds are coming out of the southeast, but the upper-level winds might be coming from the west or the southwest. So that's what makes the storm spin. You have the wind direction coming from the southeast near the surface, and way up high in the sky, it's coming from the west. And you can see, if you visualize that in your mind, how the storm might be spinning. So as these storms go across the bay, past Annapolis, they're probably going to produce water spouts.
Okay.
So if you're watching or listening over in the eastern shore, you guys should be ready for that. And again, it's really hard to see the rotation in these storms. So it's hard for Lowell or anybody to pull up the velocity of these storms. Now, what the velocity is, the radar has the capability of not only seeing where it's raining, but we can also see the wind direction inside each one of these storms. So what happens is the Weather Service will try to analyze the wind direction in each one of these storms and see that rotation, and it usually shows up as a little piece of red and green next to each other on the map. But you're not seeing that with these storms, because these spin-ups are so brief, they happen in between scans a lot of times. So
right.
That's why I'm saying anywhere along this line of storms, there's capable of a brief little tornado to spin up. So it's a really good idea to head to the basement and do your safety protocols just for a little while until they pass, even if there's not a tornado warning. And that's why I'm saying that.
Yeah, and as Tony had mentioned, I just pulled up velocity again, and yeah, you can see an area, near Cape St. Clair, where the green is pushing up against the red, and then you can also see it in a couple of other spots that are near Lakeshore and even east of Glen Burnie, more towards, again, towards Riviera Beach, Bayside Beach. So all those areas, really, folks there. And I have this graphic, this beautiful graphic that Ava made that I've been trying to showcase here. You mentioned about getting safe. Where is the safest place in my house or building? Make sure you're in a sturdy building. Go to the lowest level of that building. And if you can't get to the lowest level or there's no basement, try to go to the innermost room in the house, whether it's a bathroom or a stairwell. And above all, stay away from windows, because those can blow out with pressure changes, or debris can fly through. So those are not, I know everyone wants to look at the storm and see what's happening, but that's not a good idea.
Not the time to take pictures. Also, we always talk about, hey, send in your pictures. Don't do that right now.
Right.
And also, you guys had talked about, I think it was Ava had mentioned about, you know, if you don't know your neighbors right now and you don't feel safe right now, this is a good time to get to know them if you want to get somewhere safe and you feel like they may have a safer spot. Just go over to your neighbor, you know, get somewhere safe.
Nothing wrong with that. That's good
exactly,
advice. Yeah.
Exactly. So, yeah. So, again, those the information that you just passed on, Lowell.
Right. So I'm really just highlighting at this point the areas I've been talking about north of Annapolis, Cape St. Clair, Lakeshore, Riviera Beach. I mean, Tony also mentioned like Edgemere and then moving into portions of Harford County. I think all those folks need to be on alert at this hour, even though the tornado warning, as I'm pulling it up here, is for portions of really northern Anne Arundel County. There's a little southern swath of the city and then heading into southeastern Baltimore County. And we were mentioning earlier also, I think something just, did they just go away? I think we may have.
We hope so.
Yeah, the tornado warnings have all been dissipated for now.
Yes, just went off.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean
I know
these can't spin up.
That it can't pop up
quick.
Again.
Right.
So for a moment now, there's nothing going on. But if Lowell, if you again, I'm not in front of a TV, but
right.
If you just pull up the wide radar and you look at the line of storms, the front edge of that storm, if you're anywhere east of that line, you should be taking your safety precautions now, just in case.
Yeah,
that's
and
advice.
Tony, we're still hearing the line ringing.
Yeah, the weather radios are going nuts, as you would imagine.
Of course.
So I'm not leaving anytime soon.
We're also seeing a little bit more lightning as it's making its way towards the Chesapeake Bay here. I was about to mention that we gave fair warning too that if you know someone or you are out on the bay, get to land immediately, because the bay is no place to be in a storm like this, for sure. So.
Oh, no doubt. Yeah.
And I was mentioning to Ava a little while ago too. And Tony, even though we're now the severe thunderstorm warnings are on the eastern shore, about an hour ago they had no warnings. So now I'm thinking, you know, when we get towards some of these other counties on the eastern shore, they could probably start to. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a tornado warning as well. You know, especially Cambridge, Easton, Salisbury, and all the way towards Ocean City.
The other interesting thing about these storms is if you look at the height of the storms, the echo tops. It would be called echo tops on our system. They're not real tall thunderstorms. These are not what we would call supercell thunderstorms that are 50,000 feet high, 60,000 feet high, that you would typically see producing the really big tornadoes, you know, the twos, threes, fours. These are low top spinners, I like to call them. They're barely thunderstorms. Like you said, there's hardly any lightning in there.
Right.
But they're spinning. So that makes it even harder to see and pinpoint where these tornadoes might be. So again, in general, it would be best if you're east of that line just to take shelter. Right now, the most interesting part, if you want to call it that, might be up just to the east of Cockeysville, east of Towson, heading towards Perry Hall, Kingsville, Baldwin, in the eastern part of Baltimore County. You see that little bow that's kind of sticking out there?
Sure do, east of Cockeysville, headed towards Reckford area.
There you go. Yeah. So right in that little notch that's on the top side of the bow, that might be rotating right in there. So if you were in that little, and I'm sure Lowell is showing it to you right now, if you're in that little area of Baltimore County to the east of that line, you see they just issued a severe thunderstorm warning, because I'm looking at my own radar here at home, out ahead of that line. They didn't issue a tornado warning, but Harford County is now under a severe thunderstorm warning, and so is the eastern part of Baltimore County. And the warning probably reads, the Weather Service will issue these warnings and they'll say, tornado possible. We see rotation, but we're not going to issue a warning yet. I would just take shelter anyhow.
Right.
Lowell's showing you that spot, just do it. Yeah.
She's up at Perry Hall High School, so I know they better not be letting kids out early. Well, I know they're not.
I can't imagine.
Let me ask you guys, like in general, this is warm air and cold air mixing. Is that kind of what spawns all of this?
It's kind of like that. This is a very complicated system. Now, normally, like Sunday over the weekend, That was cold air and warm air mixing together. It was a very well-defined cold front. When the front went through, you noticed the temperatures dropped. The air mass felt a lot better. Mm-hmm. That's not what's happening here. This is with a warm front that's coming through, and the cold front is still way behind. So later on this evening, when Ava's on TV, perhaps, after this line of storms go through, there could be another one that develops behind it. Mm-hmm. So there could be two rounds of strong thunderstorms, although the atmosphere is getting kind of worked over from this one, so the second round of storms probably won't be as bad. But it's worse for tornadoes when you have a warm front going through as opposed to a cold front going through. There's more spin in the air. So this is actually a worse situation in regards to tornadoes than like Sunday over the weekend when we had the cold front go through and it was just thunder, lightning, and a lot of rain and a lot of wind.
Yeah, it's like it's almost like a perfect soup for this kind of stuff.
It's a perfect soup, exactly. Yeah. It's a good soup.
It's a good soup.
And the atmosphere is stirring it around right now, for sure.
Right. Well, let me see. There's another. So we're getting.
Yeah, you go ahead and take a look over there.
The good news is they're warnings. So our watch. They're watches and severe thunderstorm warnings, but.
Yeah, there's no tornado warnings in effect right now that I can see. So. Yeah. I don't know if we're staying on the air with this or not, but if you are,
they're staying on. Yeah, because last time we did, we said goodbye, and then 2 minutes later,
and then another one popped up
in the mix. Yeah, so
and that's probably what's going to happen here too. As soon as you signed off, another one would probably pop up.
Right. So. I was my money was on Harford or Cecil County, which I found interesting too, because they really. I didn't see earlier this morning. They were left out of the watch, the tornado watch. But now they're in the mix here for a severe thunderstorm warning just issued for Harford mm-hmm. County now and portions of the Eastern Shore and Southern Maryland.
Yeah, even if technically parts of Maryland aren't in the tornado watch, it doesn't matter at this point.
Yeah,
it's just this line of storms is coming through. And the next in line, like Lowell said, is Harford, Cecil County, Queen Anne's, and Kent County on the Eastern Shore. That's the next focus point for this. So if you're in Bel Air, for example, Kingsville is about to get hit hard. Darlington up there.
So it's moving northeast? Is that?
It's moving northeast.
Moving northeast. Okay. Mm-hmm. And you guys said it's fast. It's fast moving,
it's
right?
It's fast. It's going about 30 miles an hour, yeah. So okay. That's pretty fast.
And dumping a lot of rain. I wouldn't be surprised if it's an inch an hour type stuff coming down in the really red areas.
Well, if you talk for a few minutes, I'll pull up my home weather station here in Cockeysville, and I'll tell you exactly how much rain.
Well, while you do that, I can
we
also...
We were in Carroll County earlier, and... It's kind of pretty much moved out of there?
Yeah, it's moved out of there. Okay. But if you notice, and I'm pulling this up because we're talking about the flooding, we're still, a flood watch is in effect, I think, until around midnight tonight, simply because, as Tony mentioned also, another round of storms expected on the back end of this. Not as strong.
Not severe. Okay.
But with all the rain and the short amount of time, I really wouldn't be surprised if we saw flash flooding in portions of Harford County and Cecil County along Route 40, those areas along Route 40 into Baltimore County as well. So,
interesting, the line came through Cockeysville here about 15 minutes ago, and it only rained hard for like 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And in that 10 minutes, we picked up a quarter inch, so not a lot.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So it's good that these are moving fast.
Yeah.
The rain will likely come down really hard for a very short period of time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And what might cause the flooding, like Lowell's talking, is that second line after the ground gets soaked from this
later.
One. So.
Right. And what time is that later tonight?
I think it's like...
That would be later this evening, yeah.
Like between 8 and 11, probably.
Okay.
Yeah. I can even.
Yeah, I was surprised.
Good sleeping weather.
Good sleeping weather.
Right.
That's
I was surprised after I pulled up my home weather station here to see how little rain actually fell with that. And it rained hard for a short period of time, but it didn't last long, thank goodness. So maybe the flash flooding threat is a little lower than originally thought with this first line anyhow. So that's good.
Yeah, let's hope, because usually, those flash floods are where things can get dicey for people and we see tragedies. Mm-hmm. So hopefully That is the case. That's good news that you know, quarter inch in 10 minutes rather than an inch in 10 minutes. So
exactly.
So yeah, I'm continuing to look for some Boeing and stuff, but I'm not seeing anything. Maybe something around Edgemere here. If I'm moving out.
And Lowell, if you will, just because I'm looking at the screen now, explain the colors again. Dark red.
Just the intensity of the rainfall.
Okay.
Intensity
so dark of the red rainfall. Is the most intense.
And we also, we look for the, as we've been mentioning, we look for the areas of purple, which would most likely indicate that there's
most severe.
Hail coming down in that area. Mm-hmm. And we really only saw a couple of spots when it rolled through Columbia earlier, and they had those warnings, the tornado warnings that were in portions of central Howard County. But yeah, Tony, I'm not really seeing any much hail popping up here.
And you
either.
Probably won't.
Yeah,
you probably won't, because these are not big, tall thunderstorms like I mentioned.
Correct, right, as you mentioned, right.
Yeah, the big, tall thunderstorms, those are the ones that produce hail most of the time. These are almost more akin to the outer band of a tropical system coming through.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you get in the outer bands of, let's say there was a hurricane offshore, and you see these little bands rotating in, the thunderstorm tops might only be 25 or 30,000 feet, you know, and in comparison to the big thunderstorms that are 50,000 feet. These are more like tropical thunderstorms than the typical big, tall ones that produce baseball-sized hail and stuff like that.
Right, and I'm just taking a broader look out here. I mean, as far as a front is concerned, it's pretty well defined as far as the
area.
And that, but what this isn't show. This is just showing for our area. It's not showing for the rest of the country. But mm-hmm. I just wanted to give you a broad look here, just to see in the areas of radar in that encompass this data where. You can pretty see well defined this front that's
yeah, it's pretty,
moving through
it
the area.
Kind of seems pretty significant. I mean, we're all the way up in, what is that, Scranton?
Yeah, the storms go all the way up into central Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania, rather,
yeah.
And then all the way down to Norfolk.
Yeah, through, and they
further,
were dealing too.
South Raleigh.
Tony, there was like a surface low that was moving north through the area at the same time that this front was moving through, and I feel like down into the Norfolk and Outer Banks area, they would have some chances of seeing the possibility of some tornadoes also with this.
Oh, yeah. I mean, probably more so than us, yeah. I mean, there were a lot of tornado warnings issued down that way earlier, and bigger ones, too, like, twos and threes, at least based on some of the damage that I saw posted online,
mm-hmm.
As opposed to the ones here, which are most likely EF0s or EF1s.
Yeah.
I mean, not monster tornadoes, but these little spin-up ones. It really doesn't matter. I hate to even say that on the air because I don't want to give the impression that, oh, this is nothing and you shouldn't take shelter. Even an EF0 tornado could have 70-mile-per-hour winds that could take a tree branch and just rifle it right through your window.
Certainly.
Right. You know
earlier this week from the live desk, we had reported South Carolina and North Carolina had gotten some tornadoes.
Yeah, I just pulled up the enhanced Fujita scale. Yeah, so as Tony was mentioning, the EF1 is still very powerful at 65 to 85
miles. It's powerful enough to take a tree branch and ram it and send it through your the window of your house.
Right.
So I don't want to give the impression that even though I'm saying, yeah, most likely these are the lower end tornadoes, it really doesn't matter. You still need to take the safety precautions that we've been saying. So we can probably give it the all clear, Lowell, I would say, for severe weather, at least for now, for Baltimore City, for any place west of 83, down, even looks like it's past Annapolis now. So from the lower eastern shore up through Harford County and Cecil County, you guys are still in the mix. But west of that point, I think the threat for severe weather is over with, at least for now.
And we're seeing as it crosses over the bay here, we're starting to see a few more lightning strikes. But we just heard thunder here on TV Hill as well.
We
so, but mm-hmm. All right, we're I think they wanted us to... Well, they've given us 1 minute, Tony, so I'll just wrap up here.
Wrap it up.
Yeah, just kind of where are things going? When can we kind of see this clear out?
As Tony mentioned, the storm is now, it looks like if you just follow the lightning, it's passing through the city right now and really crossing over the Chesapeake Bay. So I feel like the people that are most in the danger line here, that would be folks in Harford County, Cecil County, and pretty much any county on the eastern shore heading towards Ocean City as well. So keep that in mind. Seek shelter. Ride this thing out. Better safe than sorry. Stay safe, and you should be okay. The good news is we really haven't seen much tornadic activity associated with this, which is good news. But again, these severe thunderstorms are nothing to take lightly. So seek shelter if you're in any of those counties where the storm is approaching that you see on radar there. Ride it out, and I would say within the next half hour to hour, things should be all right to venture out once again.